was in the October issue, but my October issue came in November. So I missed it. So not only could I believe it that there was such a great event that I could see it by getting up early in the morning and looking in the sky, low on the horizon. But even had I done it, I wouldn't have seen it. It's too late. Well, the star of Bethlehem has been a mystery over the years. People have wanted to explain it with natural explanations. Something about a comet, maybe, or an exploding star. There are many kinds of speculations, and perhaps you have seen the great programs that planetariums do at this time of the year called the Star of Bethlehem, in which they run through all the different kinds of possibilities that the star could be and run their computer backwards to the time about when they guessed that Jesus was born and show what the sky may have looked like over Bethlehem, over Jerusalem, over the Persian, Iranian, Iraq countries that the wise men came from. No comet, no known exploding star. What could it be? The Omni magazine was going with the best guess of the scientists and astronomers, that the wise men were astrologers who come from the east and had read the movement of the planets through the constellations of the stars as the planets came together in one particular constellation, that meant that a king was to be born. And so they went, not to Bethlehem, but they went to Jerusalem and inquired, where is the king to be born? We have seen his star in the east, and we have come to find him, to worship him. And indeed, the Omni magazine was pointing out that those same configurations of stars in the same constellation was occurring in October. Keep us on course. star, the dream of the star. Robert Frost, 30 years ago, wrote a poem called Choose Something Like a Star. It's a standard long poem. Talks about people following stars and wishing for stars and wishing on stars and having inspiration from the constellations and the stars. But he ends the poem with these words. So when at times the mob is swayed to carry praise or blame too far, we may choose something like a star to stay our minds and be stayed. When we seem to be without direction, and we seem to be rudderless, we seem to be floating around, being torn from one way and then the other, when the mob, or when we as individuals, when the crowd, when the nation, when the culture, whatever it is swayed to carry praise or blame too far, may choose something like a star to stay our minds and be stayed. Something to do with faith following the star. Something to do with belief that when all is said and done, something's going to work out. The Apostle Paul wrote to the church in the midst of its persecutions and its troubles, its bitterings and its arguings, its confusion, its petty grievances, its angers, and its great mission. He wrote to them about the fact that God goes with us. In the end, all things work for good. In the end, it is the Lord's rule and the Lord's winning and the Lord's battle that is won. And if we fall along the way, and if we lose our way, perhaps we can, as Robert Frost said, we can choose something like a star to stay our minds and be stayed. Something like a star. Maybe it's the star at Jerusalem, at Bethlehem, that leads the wise men from their far-off land to Jerusalem and on to Bethlehem. A combination of things that are wonderful and natural and part of our everyday life, and something miraculous that moves in on top of it all, changes it, and transforms it. We can be swayed with praise and swayed with blame. What a wonderful gift is a star to us. And so, we look for the star. The wise man reacts for us, thrilled and excited, filled with exceedingly great joy because they know their direction. They know whom they have found. May God bless us this Christmas season with the gift of the great story. Thank you. sharing of gifts and greetings and love. We thank you for our church, for the work that we do together in your name. We thank you for the concerns and cares, for the healings and the overcoming of hurts that you provide. Oh Lord, as we look into this flame, we commit ourselves anew to your service. Help our lights to so shine before this world that all people may see the good things that we do and give glory to God. Hear us as we offer all of our prayers for continuing and deepening peace in our world, for care and your presence with those who are far away. Renew our faith, hold us always in your care, and guide us in all that we do to be your faithful people. We ask in the name of Christ Jesus, our Lord. Spoke about a flame, about a lantern, that when you hold the flame up, that simply cannot be hidden. You can't even hold the handle and stop the flame without burning your hand. And Jesus said that you are all the light of the world. If your flame is under a bushel basket, it's no good at all. Just burn the basket or it will suffocate and go out. But if you let your light shine before all, it will give glory to God. Go in grace. Enjoy Christmas. The blessing of God, our Father. The love of our Lord Jesus. The fellowship.